I'm going to unbox my new Elgato Stream Deck and share with you my first impressions. The Stream Deck is basically a control pad. It has 15 customizable LCD keys that you can use to control anything on your computer. In a nutshell, you can use it to launch media, change scenes in OBS, adjust audio, start applications, open websites, and you can combine a sequence of different actions that you can automate and launch with a click of one key. I'm not the first one to buy a Stream Deck, and also not the first one to do an unboxing and review. However, the control pad is often used for live streaming by YouTubers and gamers. I will instead use it to enhance my online meeting facilitation skills. Let's go unbox it. I got it in Switzerland for 130 francs. That is approximately $130 or 125 euros. Outside of Switzerland, maybe you can get it a little bit cheaper. It's actually smaller than I thought, which is a good thing, so it won't take too much space on my desktop. And this is the quick start guide. There are three versions of the control pad. A small one, a medium one, and a large one. I got the medium one with 15 LED keys. It has a USB cable that can't be detached. This is a support. You can use it flat on your desk or lift it. Let's see what the options are. At first glance, this may be the position that I prefer. It has some rubber pieces here that make it stick to the table very well, so when you press, it doesn't move. The keys are pretty solid and provide a very nice feel when touched. The first thing is to download and install the Stream Deck app. Let's go to Stream Deck, download, and let's download the software. And the Stream Deck application launches automatically. The second step is to connect the Stream Deck directly to a USB port on the PC or Mac. Do not use a USB hub. The cable is quite long, so you can position the Stream Deck wherever you want on your desk. The third step is to launch the app to customize Stream Deck. Let's have a quick look at the preset action. Game capture actions, OBS Studio actions, this will be of interest to me, soundboard, multi-actions where you can combine multiple actions and launch them with the press of one key on the deck. Just for sake of testing, I want to add a website action. I'll put it at the top left key, and now I have to tell the deck which site it should open when I press this key. For example, I wanted to open my YouTube channel. Let me copy the URL of my channel and paste it here. Here I can change the appearance of the icon. I will put my YouTube channel logo here. Great, let's see how it looks like on the Stream Deck. My logo has a lot of white, so you can't see it very well here, but I assure you that it looks very nice on the Stream Deck. Let's see what happens when I press on it. It immediately opens a Chrome window with my YouTube channel. Let's now start populating the Stream Deck with keys. I'll start from the default profile. I will use this profile to optimize my most common actions that I can use when I'm working on different applications. In the first top left position, I will put a toggle untoggle mute button. I'll go to the audio devices menu and choose this option and select the microphone where I will apply this action. One other thing that I use pretty often is the color picker. For example, if I have to prepare some content that has to be on brand. Here, I will choose the option to display the RGB value, and I'll show you in a minute what it'll do. In the third key, I'll put a zoom in function. I use that often when I train or when I prepare how-to videos. Another function that I want to have at hand when I'm training is a timer. I directly find it in one of the Stream Deck plugins. I will then add a button that launches the Snip and Sketch app, as I'm often taking screenshots. In the middle row, I will put two buttons that open two of the folders that I open more often. I'll do the same for other applications that I commonly use. I also want to use the Stream Deck to control my Zoom meetings. There are not many keys left on this profile. But what I can do is to create a button that links to a new profile. I will dedicate this profile to all Zoom in meeting functions. And the same I'll do for OBS, a program that I use very often. Let me just fill the last buttons with other features. The CPU usage shows real-time how busy my computer is. And this becomes handy where we are simultaneously running demanding applications. And it could tell us that we should rather turn one application off to lighten the CPU. I reshuffle some icons and add Microsoft Word and Adobe Illustrator. Let's now build the zoom profile. We can do that by going to the profile menu and adding a new profile. By default, each new profile comes with a welcome button in the middle that will open the Elgato website. Let's choose the zoom icon and rename the profile to zoom. As I don't need this button, I will delete it. There's a zoom plugin that is readily available for the Stream Deck, so it becomes very easy to drag and drop all main functions, like a mute toggle button, turn on, turn off video, screen share. Then I'll put exit meeting at the bottom right, so there's a smaller chance that I press on it accidentally. Then bring zoom window to front, start recording, mute all, and so on. However, I would like to add shortcuts for more functions that I often use. Zoom has predefined hotkeys that we can find in the settings. So let's open zoom and see which are these functions. And then add some of the actions that I do more often, like switching between speaker and gallery view, enter or exit full screen mode, open or close the chat and participant panels, and so on. I will also include a button that takes me back to the default profile. So if I'm in a Zoom meeting but I want to use one of the functions that I defined in the default profile, I can always go back to it by clicking this button. And let's now see how it works. What we see on the software window is replicated in real time one-to-one on the Stream Deck. That's the mute and mute, the color picker. You see that if I move the cursor on the A of the Adobe Illustrator icon, it will pick this orange color. And the same if I move on the Windows blue, when I click the button, it will automatically display the RGB values. That's the zoom in, and if I click again, then it will zoom out, starting the timer, taking a screenshot. Let's try to open the folders and a couple of applications. Let's now look how it works with Zoom. First of all, I will open a new meeting. Actually, this is a function for which I could create a button in the Stream Deck, but let's leave it for now. So I'm now on Zoom, and I'll toggle mute and mute, turn video on and off. You see my OBS camera here. I'll try to screen share. Pause screen sharing doesn't work now because I'm not sharing at the moment. Also, the speaker or gallery view toggle doesn't work because I'm alone in the meeting now. Enter or exit full screen. Show or hide the chat or participants tab. It works just great. Do you absolutely need to have a Stream Deck? Well, the answer is probably no, but I think that when you start using it, you'll fall in love with it, as it can speed up so much all the actions that you're doing since ever. So the Stream Deck is not just for streamers, but it's a great tool to improve your work productivity.
If you like this video, consider subscribing. Now watch this next video to further enhance your productivity and communication skills. See you in my next digital tip.